Hi, Sarah here from Sarah Homfray Embroidery. Today I'm going to show you how to make these gorgeous little pin cushions, hand embroidered pin cushions in wooden bowls. I've got three designs to show you today. We have a free PDF download that you can get from the website. I'll put the link below. That's got all three patterns on it and the template to cut your fabric out as well, so you can get that there. So let's get going. Got my fabric ready in my frame. You'll need at least 15 centimeters to do this project. I've already framed this one up, and then you can print off this free PDF from our website. We'll put a link to that in the description below this video. You'll need this circle template here, so I'm going to cut this out now. So we're going to draw around the template, but we're going to do it on the reverse because we don't want a line on the front of the fabric. So you can use an ordinary pencil if you like, or if you've got one of these water soluble ones, this is an Aquatrix marker, you can use that. Just lightly draw around the circle on the back of the fabric. So we can see that on the front. I'm just going to work a running stitch around this so the running stitch shows up on the front, just using a thread that you can see. So I've got a different colour from the base, so a yellow one, and this will come out later, so it doesn't need to look very neat. So you want a longer stitch on the front and a short stitch on the back, so I'm leaving quite a gap. Short stitch on the back, long on the front. This will just mark the circle, and then we'll pull this out later. So you can see it marked on the front there. And you don't need to finish this thread off because we're just going to cut it out later. Okay, so we're ready to do some stitching. So the PDF has got three designs on it. I'm going to show you this one first, and we're just going to do some straight stitches in six strands of variegated cotton. And all I'm going to do is just start at the bottom and work my way around the shape. Quite random. Well, no, I'm just going over that running stitch around the edge, just so the stitches disappear inside the pin cushion. Not worrying too much where I put them, just randomly. You can overlap. Little short ones, longer ones. Let the colours of the variegated thread make the design for you. So I've been all the way around, and I've just done it slightly off centre, so there's more stitches at the bottom than there is at the top, just for a bit of an effect, putting the last few stitches in. I think that's probably enough. So I'm going to turn it over, and I'm going to finish my thread ends on the back, and then we'll look at the next design. So for my second design, I'm going to work this stitch here. So these are detached chains, and when you put them together they make a lazy daisy stitch. So I'm going to work these in a white stranded cotton, and I've got just four strands for these. I've just marked 5 points around the edge and one in the middle, and I'm going to work around these. This is in the pen that comes off with water, so I can get rid of these later. This just helps me to place them, but you can do it randomly if you like. So up in the fabric and down right next to it, and I'm going to make a little loop, come up in the loop, pull it tight, and that's one detached chain. Don't pull that too tight or you lose the nice loop shape. And down on the other side to finish off the stitch, and then work around in a circle. So we're going to do 5 of these for each flower. Now the next one, if you hold it out to the left hand side and then just come in a little bit, that should be in about the right place. Don't really need to measure these, so just less than 90 degrees for the second one. You should find that good distance. Up inside the loop, pull it to the outside to tension it. Don't pull it too tight or you lose your loop shape. Number 4. And then the last one to finish off. In that space there. And then we're going to put the pins. We'll make the centre of the flower. So work one in the middle and go around and work the other 5 around the edge. So just on my last flower, I got another one actually. I got 6 around the edge there because I thought that looked more balanced. So you can put as many in as you like. You could change the size of them as well if you wanted to. Last petal. Again, I've just finished my threads on the back. To tie those ends in, so that's design number 2. So for the final design, I'm going to do eyelet stitch, and I'm going to make these random and some large ones and some small ones. And for this I'm going to stitch in Madeira Lana, so this is a 50% wool, 50% acrylic, and I'm going to use 2 strands. I'm just going to start in the middle, and we're going to go round in a circle, find the centre point of your eyelet, and then we just go all the way around, going back down into that same point each time. Don't worry if they're not all the same length, you can make some longer ones, some shorter ones. Just make sure you go around in a circle to make it easier to stitch. Doesn't matter which direction round you go. One more stitch for that one. And I'm going to come up here. That's the centre for my next one, and again just round and round, going down into that point each time. So just random sizes, random positions, and I'll get to fill in the whole circle. Okay, so last eyelet just going in now. There we go. You can put as many in as you like, and I'm just going to finish these ends off, and then we'll have a look at how to make this into the pincushion. So I'm going to show you how to make this into the pincushion. So take it out of your frame. So, and then we need to measure out from the running stitch 3.5 centimetres. So 1, 2, 3.5. Put the pin in on the grain, do that on all 4 sides. Do this before you take the tacking out so that you can see clearly where the edge is. 2, 3.5. And we're going to cut the fabric to the pin. So we make a square. Now I'm going to take this tacking stitch out. So just cut through carefully on the front, and then the rest should pull out. Just cut it again if it doesn't. Just got caught in the stitches, so take all of the tacking out. Now we need this to be circular, so we're just going to fold it in half. This is the easiest way. Fold it in half again, so you've got a small square. Nice sharp pair of scissors, and we're just going to round off the corner. Like so. That will give us an approximate circle. Now you need a strong thread for this part. This is a top stitching thread because we're going to have to pull on it, so a nice strong thread. Thread it in the needle, and we're going to work a running stitch all the way around the edge. Start from the top, nice and close together with your stitches. So all the way around with a running stitch back to where you started on the top, and this is about half a centimetre in from the edge. So you've got your two ends like so. Then we're going to turn it over. We're just going to draw those threads up now. So if you just hold them both, and just start to pull and draw that into a little bowl shape. Try and even out those. That fabric around there, so that's nice and even. And we need to put our wadding inside. So we've got some here, so just a little bit at a time. And you can fill this as much as you want, so it depends how padded you want your pin cushion. Push it underneath those gathers there. Try and do it nice and evenly. If you want to see how much is in it, you can just draw those up. Can see what it's beginning to look like, so it's a bit baggy still. I'm going to put a bit more in. There, tiny bit more. That's a good shape. So now I'm just going to tie that in a knot. Pull on it gently so you don't snap that thread. Push anything inside that's coming out. Now if you've got a pair of hands, spare pair of hands, handy, this helps because this bit can be a bit tricky. So Jonathan's behind the camera and I'm going to borrow his finger if I may. Thank you. Push on nice and tightly just while I put the second knot in because it can come undone. Okay, thank you very much. And just put a couple of knots in for extra security, and if you want to sew these ends in, you can do that. I should just cut them off for speed. And then you'll just need to give it a little fiddle because it's a bit uneven with these gathers, so just manipulate it, try and get those creases out the corner. You can make it as round as you can. There we go. You can spend a bit longer fiddling with yours than I am with mine. So then you need your wooden bowl. And all we're going to do is just push it inside the bowl. You should find it's a nice fit in there. And then if you want to do a bit more fiddling, you can just get a needle and pull those gathers around just to make that edge nice and smooth. And then all we need to do now is put some pins in. So I've got some pins here. Just going to put a random selection in. There you have a gorgeous little pin cushion, handmade and hand stitched. I'll just show you what the other ones look like as well. So here's the lazy daisies that we did, and I've used red pins in here for the centres of the flower. And here's the blue one. We've got yellow pins, so they look like little daisies. So you can use your pins to help make your pattern. So three really beautiful handmade pink cushions.